he walked out on a frozen night. He was heading for the pub and he had no delight. He sat down on the railroad track and his old Gardenia sat alone in the back. He met with a dark, a staggering man as he passed him by, shouted back at him, "Matty, can't you see what's become of me? I cannot feel the fine." The very last house that I had left, half impressed with my rhymes and now all dead to me. All I got left is the beat of the stagger heading down the coral line. But Matty passed on as quick as he could. He couldn't stand such a drunken man sober. All he wanted was the lights and the bar, the Nightingale and the Wild Rover. But when he came in to say, "Now you're back to deal, you drive you out, just spouting and you're smitten. We don't want to hear about bunker hidden. Later you can give us the girls of Kincaid." As he handed him his first jar of porter, he says, "You must have seen the bishop's ghost tonight, to put the dry luck back in your eye." But Matty he'd not be taken in by the jibing and the regaling. He found himself a freshly blowing crew. He filled in with their sport and their pillin. But as he was going home in the very same spot where he met his dark familiar, he seen him coming back down the line, and he was bright, strange and fine. As he passed him by, Matty threw out his arms, trying to grab hold of his likeness. In the morning all they found was a frozen corpse at the foot of the coral line. And at the wake they were lashing down the drops of brandy, the old-fashioned tappet in the church. They were lashing down pounds and fivers, so Matty would be fine in the old by and by. Heading for the pub and he had no delight. He sat down on the railroad track and his old Gardenia sat alone in the back. He met with a dark and a staggering man as he passed him by, shouted back at him, "Matty, can't you see what's become of me? I cannot feel the fine."